Please welcome to our studio today, Professor Harold Dowson of Erlenbourg University's Archaeology Department. He is here to speak about the connection between the recent discovery of the Ship of Bones and Scandinavian mythology.
It is my opinion that the bones in the glacier were part of an early native ritual. They created a ship of bones, hoping it would have supernatural properties to pay tribute to the Scandinavian mythological ruler of the dead, Hel. The Vikings' world was steeped heavily in mythology. They believed that storms and waterspouts meant Thor was battling the world serpent. Entire poems were devoted to these battles. Thor was greatly respected by the Scandinavians. On the other hand, some deities are not mentioned a lot. An interesting fact is that the last reference to Hel was made before Thor's final battle with the world serpent.
There's no order in the city now. The garbage and withered leaves are scattered all around. I used to be a good gardener, and I rake the yard every day. How am I supposed to do that now?
Another outing? Where is your respect for my age? Once the excavation of the snowdrift was complete, the archaeologists were horrified by their discovery. It was a ship built entirely out of human bones. The news spread like wildfire and hit the headlines of all the newspapers. The city council decided that the ship would be exhibited in the local museum. Record numbers of people flocked to the museum day after day to see the chilling find with their own eyes. All the research indicated that the ship was incredibly ancient, yet scientists were amazed by its sturdy condition. More testing was required, but these plans were put on hold due to the public demand to view the ship.
Thank you.
The people were quickly caught up in a whirlwind of legends about countless riches the Vikings supposedly hid in the ship. Those hungry for easy money were quick to appear. Desperation and greed go hand in hand with riches and legends. When it was announced that the exhibition would be closed to conduct some additional research, the thieves planning to rob the museum decided not to wait. During the robbery, a shootout spilled the blood of many, both innocents and those filled with avarice and a blood rage. The blood seemed to wake the ship, causing it to glow. Shortly after the ship was discovered, Stephen Cooper, a world-renowned expert of paranormal activity, came to examine the ship. Stephen was extremely interested in studying the historic find. He inquired after reports on the ship's examination, only to be refused and mocked by the scientists conducting